down this lift. It's our year. All the way up and down the table. Isn't it exciting? Okay, let me get a head count. Steph, put the bell ahead. I wanted to get an update on the board. Has everyone who is here registered? Is the state committee member? Well, tell you what we're going to do. Put two hands. Make sure you, so that you can be counted. And let's see, there are a couple more who are on the way. We'll keep trying to text them. I'm glad the cabin's ready to get here today. We're in the choir. Child, we've got to put our communities of what we have and who they are and work even harder to get them there. Y'all, even though we are a little short on the quorum and we may not be able to vote until that happens, I think the appropriate thing to do would be to have Mike and Wise people go through the Bible. Let's go through it so that everybody has an understanding, and let's see where we are at the end of that. And then we'll take up the report from the various constituents. Okay? I'll tell you what, where's Kip? Where's Kip? After all of these, after all these cabinets, I want you to hear some other really wonderful news. Kip, before we get into discussion on bylaws, I think to fire this bunch up, let's have the finance report. You need to know where we are. Kip, you'll be welcome our treasurer, Kip Carr.
Today, July 14th, who can hear me? Who can I hear? Okay, well, I can see you now. With my report today, I would have exceeded the reports, the financial reports of my last two. Your assessment was DPG Treasurer. Today, our Treasurer's report showcases positive movements by our state party in both income and expenditures. The positive numbers show not just a good month here or there, rather they reflect the intentional building of a strong financial infrastructure that will remain sustainable for some time to come. We're on a good, solid trajectory for operating in the black and at a functional capacity. We started out the year with money in the bank. In fact, our CFO, who has been with the party for nearly two decades, stated that this was the healthiest financial shape that the party has ever been in. Now, we did that by increasing our grassroots and our digital raises. We also ran a very, very lean machine, which is what we've been doing for the last 2 years or so. When our director of finance moved on in October of last year, Mr. Buckner, we did not replace him for 5 months. Rather, our executive director, Rebecca, did both jobs for nearly half of the year. Well, what does that mean? That means that we saved money where we could and made sure that we squirreled away the federal funds that would be so precious to us today. Two statement of cash balances indicate our COH, cash on hand, as of July 1st, 2018, 18. Additionally, the coordinated campaign is run through the 2018 victory accounts, both federal and non-federal. Additionally, we have a levy account which allows us to retroactively turn non-federal dollars into levy dollars, allowing us more flexibility in carrying out generic federal election activities. We want to thank our Grassroots Georgia program. I asked Jeff Tiley for some numbers for the past few years so the folks can really appreciate how the programs that we have developed and continued has grown. In conclusion, we are on a trajectory that allows us to play our best role in the election season. Now, something very sorrowful will happen on November 7th, 2018. I see Peter smiling in the audience. For on that day, campaigning will cease. But your state party will not. And so we will need to continue our work and grow and be nimble for the needs of Democrats. The budget and our cash on hand will allow us this stability. You see before you our statement of cash balances.
What was it?
Is there any questions? Okay.
We can't hear you.
$1.9 million. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much. As I stated on January 31st, 2015, when I ran for this position, I simply promised the state committee that you would get a financial report. That is all that was required or expected of me. I believe I have been more than capable of adhering to that requirement.
Thank you. Here we are, where we are in the country in raising money for our statewide candidates this year. Y'all, this didn't happen by an accident. But because of the quality of the candidates we have, the governor's race on down, we're attracting money nationally. In our field program, it is amazing, out of the Democratic Party, our campus team is breaking record after record in neighborhoods. This is what it's going to take to win. Thank you for your hard work on this. Yes. Well, it's designated, it's a Smith brand.
Can you repeat the question?
What she asked was part of the DNC money that we received a grant for, the Max Blaney State Party can get was $100,000. We're getting $100,000 of that. Some states got part of it, we got fully funded. That is for our ground program. That is for our field teams. That is for building out the get out and vote efforts that we'll be rolling out in conjunction with the April's campaign and the statewide candidates this year. That's where it is. Okay, anything else? All right, with that, then let me turn it over now, next to Mike Jablonski, to go through the bylaw changes.